blindfold. Perhaps it is better to die in complete darkness. Nobody move! I've got those guns. Throw them in the bushes. Over there! Quick! Now everybody back! Back! Now you. Get the horses!
It'll be hard to catch him in the dark.
We'll catch him, all right. We made a great mistake. Now he's got to die a second time. Good morning.
There's a sign over there that says no trespassing.
I don't pay any attention to signs.
Well, you'd better pay attention to this one. This is Barkley property.
I intend to leave nothing but my footprints, and I'll rub them out if you insist. Why, you'd be one of the Barkleys, huh?
Yes, and you?
Eric Mercer.
Well, you're lucky no one shot at you. We've been having a lot of trouble up here lately.
None that I've caused, I assure you. I'm only a trespasser, and I'm armed with nothing but a book of poetry. Thank you. I'm about to make some coffee. You want some?
No. You're the first man I've met who reads poetry.
No? I'm sorry, I'm the first. Poetry's shorthand of the soul.
What kind of poems are in that book?
Whitman, Coleridge, Shelley, Shakespeare.
Who do you like best?
Hard to say. We are such stuff as dreams are made of, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. So I slept here last night. Do you begrudge me that?
We're not too happy with fence jumpers.
You are a mass of cliches, girl. That's one. What do you care about fence jumpers if they take nothing, hurt nothing, just look? Why? Do I contaminate the air you breathe?
Of course not. I suppose it's just that you're not supposed to be here without permission.
That's what I mean about signs. They're the outward evidence of conformity.
You can stay here tonight. And I'm not a conformist.
Rebellion. The first sign of sanity. Well, perhaps you do have a chance after all. All right. I accept your kind invitation.
I'm looking for a black gelding, stands 15 hands. If you see him, you might bring him by the ranch. It's just a mile north of here.
If I do, I'll bring him to you. In a jeweled box, princess. That's pretty. Sorry I'm late.
Oh, I hope you had dinner on the trail because we polished off all that wild duck.
Oh, Jared, there's plenty of duck in the warmer.
Well, I had some tasty dry jerky up on the ridge. I'll just have some coffee.
Did you find out who butchered that steer?
What steer?
Oh, Heath found the remains of an animal up on the North Ridge day before yesterday.
Yeah, there are three more gone out of the herd in the high grass. And the black gelding still missing.
Well, some of those saddle tramps ride through there.
Saddle tramps don't usually kill cattle. Or steal horses.
Well, somebody's working that area over. We better keep our eyes open.
Audrey, you were up on the ridge today, weren't you?
Yes.
Did you see anything suspicious?
Nothing suspicious.
Any more fence down?
Just the one on the strip.
Well, that one's been down for a week.
Audrey, would you give me a hand? I'm having trouble with that petty point.
Sure.
Are you still cutting poles for it?
Yeah. I think we better start working over all those fence posts.
Now, hold that there, good and tight.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Now we'll tack it. How long were you up on the North Ridge?
Oh, a little while.
Did you make a fire?
No.
Well, you must have passed through a burned area somewhere. With smudges on your riding pants. Do you want to tell me about it?
How do you always know?
Well, that comes with practice.
I met someone on the North Ridge. He wasn't doing any harm. I told him he could stay there tonight.
Well, you better tell your brothers about it.
Oh, they're always making too much out of nothing. I'll write up in the morning and make sure he's gone.
How'd you find that?
How did you?
Oh, well, I saw you here. Sis, I wouldn't come back up here alone till we find out who made that.
All right. We're going back slow and easy. This is a fellow that's been helping himself to our stock. I found a steer killed and butchered right on his route, and he was leading the Black Gelding.
Who are you? Eric Mercer.
You've made a mistake. I asked him to watch for the black horse and to bring it to me when he found it.
You asked him?
Yes, I asked him, and I gave him permission to camp on our land.
You gave him permission, huh?
Yes.
When?
Yesterday.
For which I thank you, Princess, and I was bringing the horse back to you.
Well, what were you doing up there?
Passing through.
Where were you going?
The islands under the wind.
Why did you run when I asked you to stop?
You had a gun. I didn't.
Audra, San Diego for Dr. Morrell. Boys, carry him into the library.
You had a concussion when you fell off that horse. Often happens, the reaction is delayed. I recommend the next few days you rest.
Rest? Universal panacea.
Don't joke about it. It is the universal panacea. I'll see you again in a few days.
You can stay on here if you like for a while until you're a little steadier.
No, I'll camp up on the ridge if it's all right with you.
Mercer, I made a mistake. I'm sorry.
I shouldn't have run away like Horatio. I should have held the bridge.
You need the rest. Please stay.
No, thank you. Walls close in on me.
Well, there's a place to stay a couple of miles behind the house.
Yeah, a grove of trees. Plenty of water. You can camp there.
I'll do that.
I'll give you a hand.
Thanks.
I wonder who he is.
Just a traveler bringing back one of our horses. Maybe. But I intend to find out.
He's up in those hills somewhere.
Sure?
I'm sure. That horse of his throws his right front foot. You can't mistake it.
Things are something worth to me. The wondrous motion of a horse, the clouds that crown the peaks, the roaring sea.
What makes you talk like that?
What makes you like this horse? He's poetry. Oh, yes. Like the sun when it rips across the valley, or clouds rising like fists in the sky, that's poetry. Look, this leaf is poetry. See?
I've often wondered, why do most poets worry so about life?
Because it's very short. Because most people don't even taste it. Most of them are dead when they're 25. They never think or feel again. How to be alive is to savor every moment. To see the pattern of the whole in a thousand little things.
I'll have to think about that.
Time you did.
The family's been wondering how you are.
Well, my vision's clear. My appetite's good.
Will you be staying with us long? You might like it here.
I do, but I can't stay.
Where will you go?
West.
Why?
Because I must.
You think you'll be coming back this way?
I don't think so.
Well, then before you leave, you ought to get to know some of the people in the valley. They're very nice. We're having a party tonight. Will you come?
You don't get to know people at parties.
Yes, you would.
No, you go through the motions. Talk about the same unimportant things you talked about at the last party.
You know, I think you're a snob.
Just the time is too precious to be wasted.
When will you leave exactly?
Soon. Time's running out for me.
Audra, the guests are beginning to arrive.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll be right down.
Can I be of any help?
No, thank you.
I have a message for you. John Baxter says to save the first dance for him.
Oh.
Well, I was under the impression you were fond of John.
Oh, he's nice. I didn't mean it to sound that way.
All right, Audra, something is the matter. What is it?
I invited him to come to the party tonight, Mother. And he practically threw the invitation in my face.
You're talking about Mr. Mercer?
Yes. He was so sure he'd be bored to death here. I've never met anyone like him. Well, maybe it's good that he's not coming. He's rude and I don't understand him at all. I don't know whether he likes me or thinks I'm an absolute waste of time. But I know I want to see him again.
Perhaps there will be another opportunity.
He's leaving.
When?
I'm not sure.
Well, if he's a man of taste and judgment, I'm sure he'll say goodbye to you before he leaves.
I thought you'd be against him.
Why?
Because he's a stranger and you know nothing about him.
Audra, I'd feel much better if I knew who he was and what he was doing in the valley. I am concerned about him. But until he proves he can't be trusted, there's nothing I would say to discourage you. Now you hurry and get dressed.
You came after all. The most confusing man. Stay a few days, Eric. Stay. What do you see up there?
Auriga. Perseus, Ares, the Pleiades. Worlds beyond worlds. And worlds beyond that, millions upon millions of them. Endless grains of cosmic sand. You know, you make even this world seem important. I'll stay, Audra. As long as I can.
What can I say, senor?
What are you going to do with that stare?
Oh, I'm going to cook it.
We've lost 4 steers in the last 5 days. Nobody can eat that much meat.
Oh, but I cook for a lot of people, senor.
Where do you find these lot of people?
They're over the hill. They have a camp there.
And I suppose you take us on over the hill.
Go on, move.
This man working for you?
He cooks for us. We can call it cooking.
Then you owe us $38.
What for?
For the beef he's killed to feed you.
Well, we paid him for the meat.
But he forgot to buy it. Decided to steal it instead.
What'd you do with the money?
The cockfights.
Oh, now that's no problem of ours, mister. Come on, pay up.
What are you gonna do with him?
Take him out into town, maybe turn him over to the sheriff.
See. Give him the money, Ben.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant.
Lieutenant?
You're looking at D Company of the 12th Cavalry, or what's left of it.
Well, what are you doing here?
We're looking for a man named Mercer. Eric Mercer. Ever hear of him?
Should we have?
No. I just thought I'd ask.
What do you want with him? What has he done?
I can tell you this much. He killed 63 men.
Saving this for last. Beautiful, isn't it?
Yes.
See that ledge down there on the right? That's called the judgment seat. I've always wanted to sit there.
Why?
You're always asking why. I'll tell you why. Because it would give me a feeling of power.
Oh, like Zeus with his thunderbolts. I wouldn't try it. You'd have to be scraped up.
I could make it. Eric, for a man who doesn't like rules, you have a bad habit of making them.
There's a difference between conformity and recklessness.
What made you a nonconformist?
The war. The most dreadful conformity of them all. Blind, deaf, unfeeling. I played with death, substituting rules and slogans for thought. No more.
Eric, how will you live?
Hmm?
I talked to Nick about you. He has a job for you in the ranch, if you like.
That would be disaster. No, thank you.
Are you going to go on wandering around the world?
That's right.
Why?
You shouldn't meddle, Audra.
I don't know you. I don't know how to talk to you.
Hey, don't go up there.
I, like you, Eric, will do as I please.
Don't be a fool, Audra! Audra, don't be a fool! Audra!
Help, Eric! Help!
Take a deep breath.
Don't move. Don't do anything. Now I have to go back to the horse to get a rope. You understand? Now I'll be right back, but whatever you do, don't try to move.
Now just hold on. I'll be there in a minute.
Tie this rope around you. Take it easy. Okay, don't look down. Now I'm gonna climb back to the top and pull you up.
Oh, don't leave.
I said don't look down. Just hold onto the rope. I'll be up there in a few minutes. You'll be all right, I promise you.
As I pull, keep your feet braced against the rock and keep stepping up, all right? Okay.
Oh, was foolish, wasn't it?
Here's the great leveler. Keeps you, humble.
Then I humbly ask you to dinner tonight.
I accept with pleasure.
Audra said she wanted to show him the ranch, but if I know Audra, she's probably showing him the entire valley.
Yeah, well, they should have been back here long ago. They're not back in 10 minutes.
Well, Audra, what happened?
Well, I just had a little fall. I'm all right. Mother Eric's staying for dinner.
Well, you're very welcome. What happened?
She decided to climb down a hill. It turned out to be an alp.
I fell. He saved my life.
Where were you?
On the cliff by the judgment seat.
I'm grateful. My daughter is very precious to me.
With good reason, Mrs. Barkley.
Mr. Mercer, I guess we owe you sort of an apology. We found a Mexican cook that's been stealing our beef and feeding it to some men camped on the other side of the draw.
How many men?
8, 9, more or less. Ex-soldiers.
Union soldiers?
Yes, I'd say. They seem to know you.
You'll forgive me, Mrs. Barkley, if I don't stay to dinner. There's something I must do.
Somebody better tell her.
Eric! What's wrong?
It's over, Princess.
You're leaving?
As soon as I pack my gear.
You said you'd stay.
I'd stay for a time, I said. Time's up.
Are you angry with me? Is that it?
No. Angry? You can't be angry with a wraith, a spirit, an idea. It's just time to go.
Just like that? Just go? Do I have to shame myself?
That you would never do. But I'd shame you if I stay.
Understand him, Mother. He's leaving. What'll I do?
Do you love him, Audra?
I think so.
When I was your age, there was a young man, and he was gentle, poetic, wise. Unfortunately, he was also an embezzler. And one day they came and took him away.
What are you saying, Mother?
There's a group of ex-soldiers camped over beyond the North Ridge. They're looking for Eric.
Why?
They say he killed 63 men.
Eric? Killed? I don't believe it.
I didn't think you would, but you saw his face when Nick told him about those men. He's running away from them, Audra.
Has anyone talked to him? Asked him what happened?
No, not yet.
Well, don't you think someone should? You know, everyone thought he stole that gelding, too. There could be a mistake. Who are those men, anyway? They aren't deputies.
No, they aren't.
I won't believe anyone, Mother, till I've talked to Eric.
I never wanted that.
You never wanted anything. That's what's wrong with you. You won't accept anything from anyone.
Audra, they say just before a man dies, every nerve in his body comes to life in some great soaring flare of the spirit. We were caught in that kind of fire. But now it's time for you to go back to your family.
Stop talking that way and tell me the truth.
What do you want to know?
Why are those men after you?
You know about that. All right. There were 71 men left in my company. They had us holed up for 3 days. I mean, Kataro, an Apache chief, and 200 of his men. Another company was coming up the river to pull us out. But I didn't know that. Anyway, Kataro called for a parley. He offered to stop fighting if I'd give up, turn the company over to him. He said he'd hold us for ransom, $100 apiece. Well, I knew him. I thought I could trust him. We wouldn't have had a chance anyway if we kept fighting, so just had to take his word for it. I was a fool. Kataro tied us all to stakes, with me last so I could watch. And they dug a pit and made a fire in it. And one by one, they threw my men into it. One by one. There were only 8 men left by the time help arrived. Well, the army let me resign without a court-martial, but not the men. And when their enlistments ran out, they started looking for me. You know, Morrison and the others. Now you know.
Eric? Aren't you tired of running?
Yes.
Stay.
They said they'd come to the end of the world after me.
You'll be safe here.
Perhaps this is the end of the world.
Ma'am, my name's Morrison. This is Ben Wilkins.
Come in, gentlemen.
We're looking for a killer, ma'am.
Oh, there's no killer in this house.
Well, somebody has a camp up behind the house.
Is that any concern of yours?
We've seen him through the glasses.
You've been watching us?
Mrs. Barclay, we want that man badly.
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Can't or won't?
If you'll excuse me, gentlemen.
Mrs. Barclay, Ben didn't mean anything. Excuse me. Perhaps you could help us, young lady. We're looking for this man.
We're not interested in your pictures.
We'd like your permission to search the hills behind the house.
No one searches this place. Not you, not anyone, for any reason.
You won't harm the place in any way. But I'm sorry, ma'am, with or without your permission, we are going to search those hills.
Well, there are 34 men on this ranch. You want to fight your way through them?
They're working roundup. Take them a day to get here.
Won't take the sheriff a day to get here.
No, it'll take him about 3 hours. More time than we'll need.
You ask for a fight, Mr. Morrison. You'll get it.
Mrs. Barclay, we've been through a war. One fight, more or less, won't bother us too much. Ben, good day, ladies.
They know, Audra.
They'll kill him, Mother. I'll ride up to the camp and warn him.
Send him to the line shack. I'll get the boys. They know another trail out of there.
Man is running, he has two choices. Keep running or stop. If I run, I'll be caught by them in a short time. If I stop, I'll be caught by them in a shorter time. Makes no difference.
There's a line shack just over the ridge. My brothers will come and meet us there. Please.
All right. The line shack it is. Thanks, you can go back now.
I'm not going till my brothers get here.
I don't want you here, Audra. You've helped me. I thank you. Now go.
No. We'd better get the horses out of sight.
Tracks lead off towards that hill over there.
Well, let's check it out.
Brothers will be here soon.
Sure. I look at you and I know that I miss most of the good things in life.
You know I love you, Eric.
Not really, Audra. Love transforms two ordinary human beings into a special something. It's a special kind of life. It has to go on for a long time or it's nothing. This is a moment, a sample of something you'll have someday. Audra. Audra, promise me. You mustn't love the dead.
Like our friend has got company.
Pete and Nick.
All right, Audra, you can leave now.
No.
This is no place for you.
I won't go till I know he's safe.
All right, now you go get your horses. Heath will take you out the back way. Now, come on, move.
It's a waste of time. They'll find me wherever I go.
Look, mister, we're willing to do everything we can to help you out, but we're not going to get ourselves killed in the process. Now, come on, get.
I'm staying here.
Do you want to get yourself killed?
I've been running for 2,500 miles. I stop here.
You're getting to be an awful lot of trouble, mister.
Nick, please.
Heath, they're coming. I'll stall them as long as I can. You get them out of the back way. Now, come on, move. Let's go.
Eric, you told me that living was the most important thing in the world. It is for you, too.
Audra.
Please.
Take this.
Mercer! Mercer! You may as well come out! Dismount.
Lieutenant, I want to talk to you.
We've got no quarrel with you, Barclays. Ride out, we'll hold our fire. We just want Mercer.
What good's killing him gonna do you?
Send him out. It's no concern of yours.
Well, you happen to be on Barclay land. That is a concern of mine.
Now, don't be a fool, young fella. We'll kill Barclays if we have to. We've come too far to stop now.
You come any closer and it will be too far.
Come on, let's go.
Get him out of there. It's finished.
What are you doing home in the middle of the day?
Oh, well, it's kind of quiet around the office. My clerk said I was just in the way, so... All right, I wanted to take a look in on Audra. She's still in her room?
Mm-hmm.
How is she?
Oh, it's going to take time.
Well, it's been 3 days. Seems to me that's time enough.
She was in love. She's never been hit this hard.
Well, I know, but we can't just let her sit in that room. We gotta snap her out of it. Take a look at this. Isn't that a beauty? That's the one she's been admiring down at Bandy's. This may help.
Jared, not just yet. There's nothing we can say or do or give to her that will change how she feels right now. Let her grieve, Jared. Let her do it in her own way and be done with it.
Well, guess maybe you're right. I guess this can wait. I have some mail I better check in the study.
I'm going riding my way up to the North Ridge.
Have you had your lunch?
No, I wasn't hungry. Don't worry, Mother. I'm all right. Really, I am. You know, Mother, I learned something. Eric said that to live every second is the most important thing in the world, and that's exactly what I'm going to do right now.
Thank you.
blindfold. Perhaps it is better to die in complete darkness.
Nobody move! I've got those guns. Throw them in the bushes. Over there! Quick! Now everybody back! Back! Now you. Get the horses!
It'll be hard to catch him in the dark.
We'll catch him, all right.
We made a great mistake. Now he's got to die a second time.
Good morning.
There's a sign over there that says no trespassing.
I don't pay any attention to signs.
Well, you'd better pay attention to this one. This is Barkley property.
I intend to leave nothing but my footprints, and I'll rub them out if you insist. Why, you'd be one of the Barkleys, huh?
Yes, and you?
Eric Mercer.
Well, you're lucky no one shot at you. We've been having a lot of trouble up here lately.
None that I've caused, I assure you. I'm only a trespasser, and I'm armed with nothing but a book of poetry. Thank you. I'm about to make some coffee. You want some?
No. You're the first man I've met who reads poetry.
No? I'm sorry, I'm the first. Poetry's shorthand of the soul.
What kind of poems are in that book?
Whitman, Coleridge, Shelley, Shakespeare.
Who do you like best?
Hard to say. We are such stuff as dreams are made of, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. So I slept here last night. Do you begrudge me that?
We're not too happy with fence jumpers.
You are a mass of cliches, girl. That's one. What do you care about fence jumpers if they take nothing, hurt nothing, just look? Why? Do I contaminate the air you breathe?
Of course not. I suppose it's just that you're not supposed to be here without permission.
That's what I mean about signs. They're the outward evidence of conformity.
You can stay here tonight. And I'm not a conformist.
Rebellion. The first sign of...
blindfold. Perhaps it is better to die in complete darkness.
Nobody move! I've got those guns. Throw them in the bushes. Over there! Quick! Now everybody back! Back! Now you. Get the horses!
It'll be hard to catch him in the dark.
We'll catch him, all right.
We made a great mistake. Now he's got to die a second time.
Good morning.
There's a sign over there that says no trespassing.
I don't pay any attention to signs.
Well, you'd better pay attention to this one. This is Barkley property.
I intend to leave nothing but my footprints, and I'll rub them out if you insist. Why, you'd be one of the Barkleys, huh?
Yes, and you?
Eric Mercer.
Well, you're lucky no one shot at you. We've been having a lot of trouble up here lately.
None that I've caused, I assure you. I'm only a trespasser, and I'm armed with nothing but a book of poetry. Thank you. I'm about to make some coffee. You want some?
No. You're the first man I've met who reads poetry.
No? I'm sorry, I'm the first. Poetry's shorthand of the soul.
What kind of poems are in that book?
Whitman, Coleridge, Shelley, Shakespeare.
Who do you like best?
Hard to say. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. So I slept here last night. Do you begrudge me that?
We're not too happy with fence jumpers.
You are a mass of cliches, girl. That's one. What do you care about fence jumpers if they take nothing, hurt nothing, just look?
Why? Do I contaminate the air you breathe?
Of course not. I suppose it's just that you're not supposed to be here without permission.
That's what I mean about signs. They're the outward evidence of conformity.
You can stay here tonight. And I'm not a conformist.
Rebellion. The first sign of sanity. Well, perhaps you do have a chance after all. All right.
I accept your kind invitation.
I'm looking for a black gelding stands 15 hands. If you see him, you might bring him by the ranch. It's just a mile north of here.
If I do, I'll bring him to you. In a jeweled box, princess.